you tell me what it means then to be asexual?
Well, being asexual just means experiencing little to no sexual attraction. So I like to think of it as the sexual orientation that just isn't oriented anywhere.
And that's, I mean, when did you, how did this come about then that you found this out? Was it just through the fact that you felt different to your friends about when they were fancying them and you weren't? How did it work?
Well, I didn't learn the term until I was about 15, but I'd always, like, known I was asexual, and I feel like I worked it out around the same time as everyone seemed to realize that they weren't asexual. I feel like there's a point in life where everyone seems pretty asexual, and then, like, puberty kicks in and the hormones kick in, and then it kind of changes, and that's when I thought, okay, I'm not really feeling the same way as everyone else,
yeah.
But I assumed it would kick in.
Yes, and so... You assumed it would kick in and you thought maybe I'm just, you know, taking it a bit slower than everyone else. And then when it didn't, how did you feel?
Honestly, I wasn't particularly concerned about it, but other people were. And it was everyone else's kind of projections onto me that made me start to wonder, like, oh, is this something I should be concerned about? But I mean, at the time, you know, you're a teenager, you're in school, you've got homework, you've got all these other things you're thinking about. So I was like, this is one less worry.
Yeah.
But for everyone else, that was like a primary worry. And then I started to then worry about it.
Yeah. And then when you kind of gave it the label of asexuality, what did that feel like? And what kind of impact did that have on your life?
Well, I mean, I felt like other people kind of gave me the...
Yeah.
Because everyone would try it, and they'd quiz me, and they'd try and work it out, and eventually someone said, maybe you're asexual. And then I Googled it, and I had that weird phenomenon of seeing complete strangers with the same life experiences as me, and I realized, like, okay, it's not just me. This is an actual thing. It's a sexual orientation. There's nothing wrong with me. But at the same time... no one else knows what you're talking about. So it was like half helpful.
Yeah.
It's not like being able to say, oh, I'm gay, and people know what that means, and they just kind of accept it as a thing. So it was, I now knew I had something. I knew what it was. I knew it was legitimate, but people still didn't really believe me for a long time.
Yeah, because I imagine, how many times have you been asked or been told, oh, you've just not met the right person yet?
Countless on the daily.
Yeah.
I've been literally getting the exact same things of, you're too young to understand, from the time I was 9 to now at 24 years old, being told that, you know, maybe there's just something physically wrong with you, mentally wrong with you, maybe you think you're too good for anybody, it's a personality issue, or reflection of bad life experiences. I've heard, you name it, I've heard it. I've heard some ridiculous stuff.
So what do you say in response?
To all those, I mean, it kind of depends which one. I think the common one when people just say you haven't found the right person yet, as though that's going to, like, activate your sexual orientation or change your sexual orientation. I like to turn that around on people because that logic is very flawed. So if, like, I know a straight guy says to me, like, oh, you're not asexual, you just haven't found the right man yet. I'm like, okay, well, maybe you're gay and you just haven't found the right man yet. It's the same logic, right?
Yeah.
You're going to meet someone and that's going to somehow change your sexual orientation. And there are also loads of asexual people that have found their soulmates. And being sexually attracted to someone does not necessarily mean they're the right person for you. I think anyone can vouch for that.
So what does it mean in terms of relationships for you? Like, are you, you know, looking for someone to have a platonic relationship with then? Or are you just not bothered about having a kind of soulmate, as you might say?
Personally, I'm not interested in romantic relationships either. I don't experience romantic attraction either. That's not specifically an asexual thing. That's just kind of how I am. So I'm more focused on, you know, platonic relationships. And you can have, you know, platonic relationships that where the person is like a life partner. And, you know, you could get a mortgage with your best friend.
You could
do all those things. So, yeah, I just place more emphasis on platonic relationships. I don't really see them as being beneath romantic relationships in terms of, like, significance.
Yeah. And so, again, you know, I know very little about this, so it's really interesting talking to you about it, because if you were to meet someone and... like, can you still fall in love is what I'm trying to ask, I guess. Like, do you still have that as a feeling?
Romantically... no, not really. It's not really. I feel like I'm not really wired that way. But you can have that kind of, like, a platonic attraction. You can meet people where you think, well, like, we really vibe. let's hang out all the time. I want to talk to you all the time. I want to, like, know you for the rest of my life. Like, let's work our lives around each other. You could have that with someone that you're not romantically in love with.
Yeah.
Like, I can still experience love like everyone else. Just, it just isn't in the romantic way.
So then if you meet someone who you love in a platonic way, but then they want to make it more romantic and they want to be sexual, are you kind of just not ruling that out as a thing? Or, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, sorry about that, but it's a no.
Yeah. I mean, does that worry you at all? Or are you just, because you're so incredibly confident, which is brilliant. But does anything worry you about it?
Not really. Yeah. I mean, it's awkward if, you know, you're friends with someone, and then I think anyone, even if you're not asexual, you can vouch for having that kind of friendship where you realize they were trying to date you the whole time. I think that's awkward for anybody. But fortunately, nowadays, most people know I'm asexual, so I think they know they're barking up the wrong tree with that one.
And what, just, you know, because there might be some people watching where this is the first time they've heard this and it really resonates with them personally. So what would you say to anyone who's sitting there thinking, actually, gosh, maybe that's me. Maybe I'm asexual and I've just never been able to define it before.
I would say that there is nothing wrong with you, because we're kind of taught that there is something physically or mentally wrong with you and that you're not going to be able to live a fulfilling life, or your people are going to treat you differently and you're going to feel like you're missing out on something. So I would just say that, you know, it's totally normal. You can live a very awesome life, and there is a whole community of millions of asexual people out there. And as time progresses, we're talking about it a lot more, and you're fine. You're good. Live your life.